Hi everyone, so happy you took the time again to come over and watch a new video from Diana Me. For everyone who is new here and sees me for the first time, my name is Yanni and I'm doing this channel together with my daughter-in-law Diane. Today I am joining the beautiful Fanny from Creations by Favi, I hope I say it right. And of course the beautiful Maria from Crafting with Maria. I will place a link down below with both the ladies, their beautiful channels, so go check it out. Give them some love and subscribe to their channels. And of course, I will place also a link down below with the playlist with tons of beautiful inspiration for you. Today, I am so happy because they came up with a beautiful challenge, which is called Twine It Up Challenge. And I love working with twine, so I had so much fun making my DIY. I hope you enjoy watching this content and you like a little bit of chaos. I hope you also will consider subscribing to the Diana My channel. And if you do, like I always say, enough talking, let's jump into our DIY. So this is a little bit what I will use for this DIY. You see here my arrows I use for a DIY and for my decor for the fall season. But it didn't stay right on my wooden panel, so I'm reusing my arrows again. I will pull the print off, so we will see how that will go. But the main thing we have to use is, of course, for this DIY, is this twine. We have to use twine in our DIY, so I will use this twine. Of course, I used some couple of houses, wooden houses I bought on Amazon. So if you like this one, I have them in several different measurements. So if you like this, go check out Amazon and they are very cheap for a good quality. Here you see some little fence and some bicycles from wood. I bought this one on AliExpress. So if you like that, go check it out. AliExpress had so many beautiful wooden things to decorate with. They can be trees, leaves, you name it, and they have it. And most of the time the sending is free. So, but I don't have an idea what I will do in my little wooden houses. So we will see when the DIY is coming along. We will see what will come up. So we just start our DIY and we will see what will happen. So here you see the arrows I used. And of course I will want to reuse them and I want to paint them again. So I'm going to try to get the... Oh, this is going easy. You see, because when it was outside, the mud pots already did his job and he doesn't stay on top of it. So I will paint this one in the black schoolboard color, and then we are going to do some twine from here to here. So, but first I'm going to paint him over again and then I show you how we are going to do the twine. So I think you already saw me do this a couple of times. You see, I use this schoolboard paint and I really love this paint the last couple of months, because for this I always spray painted it, and I, of course, I liked it too, but when I found this, I am really happy with the matte finish that it gives your DIY or your craft, just how you call it. So, but you see, for me, I didn't need to do this piece to paint it, but I am a crazy, crazy lady sometimes. So I am always painting also the things I don't have to paint. It's not really, really a smart thing to do, but I always love that for me it is finished. So I am going to do this and I will do the rest out of camera and then I will be back with you. Now my arrows are dried up. You see, they are totally dry right now. What I'm going to do right now, because I want to have the middle with twine, so I will do one arrow beside and then I'm going to glue. You see already still where my wooden piece turned out. He is already here. What I'm going to do is just do a little piece of glue over here. And I'm just doing it this way, is a little bit better. Just glue it on top of here. But I think you already know that you don't glue yourself like I am. But push it a little bit harder that it will stay in place. And what I'm going to do, because you already saw that I have a little piece, I need to get exactly over here, so I have to be in the corners, or else it will look not the greatest. So do just a little piece over here. I'm try to use less glue as I can, because or else I had a time that I did my glue with a face, and you could see a lot of glue coming through the little rope, and I don't, that's not really a nice way to see, but that was my first time. So I'm going to try to do the glue on the back side and not on the front, because or else you will see that sometimes a little pieces I will do a little bit of glue, or else it doesn't stick in totally. So I'm going to do this one over here and just squeeze it in. And when I did a couple of turns, then I will glue it again. So you see, I did a couple of turns. Now I'm going to do a little bit of glue over here. And I just lay my rope inside of here. And just do a couple of turns again, and just do it again. And if you need to, just push it a little bit this way so you get it real close. But I think you already a little bit know what I mean. I show you when I'm a little bit further, I show you how everything is looking like. But I do that out of camera, or else, like I would say, some people find it very boring if I am only showing you this way. So I'm going a little bit further and then I show you how this is looking like. So I promised I would show you a little piece when I'm halfway. I already did this one, you already see. And I am doing on the back, I do some glue. And I'm just turning it around, because for my hands that's a little bit better, because I have an issue on my hands. So if you have no problem with your hands, maybe you have a better way to do it. But this is a little bit more better for my hands. So you see how easy it is. You just turn it around, and now you don't have glue also on the good side. That's what I like a little bit. You learn while you are doing your DIYs, because the last time everything was under the glue. So I am just doing it this way and just turn it around, and you just can see how an easy arrow, I think he was from the when I bought it, it belongs to the wedding decor, but you see, you still can use it for the every season you want. So just do some glue again and just turn it around. Just take the a piece of your arrow and just, and you just every time you push it through the glue, so it will stick on one side. See, and now I will finish it off and then I show you both of them. So here you see both of them are finished right now. What I'm going to do right now first is going to give my little wooden house a color. I think I'm going, it won't surprise you, I'm going for the color black, but after that he will change up, so he doesn't stay black. But for underground I will use the black color, because what I'm going to try to do is to get one of the houses on each arrow. I will glue this one on top of it, so I will first do the undercut in the black. And then I'm going to do something with the houses, and of course a little bit with the arrow, because they are now a very plain black. So I probably will distress it a little bit, and here we're going to work with afterwards. But first I'm going to put it in the underground of the black color. So you see, I am busy to coloring my little wooden houses. And this time, what I normally do, like I always said, I always paint also the pieces I don't have to paint. But this time I don't do the backside, because I am going to glue them on top of my arrow, but if I have glue in between it, it doesn't it sticks less than I don't have the paint is on here. So I will leave this open because I want to glue it on top of my arrow. So that's why I'm this time not gluing it, or not painting it. I'm sorry. I am not painting it, so I just do the sides and the inside of my house, and it doesn't have to be a very big coat, just a light coat of black, because you still are going to change it up. But I always like that the coloring is also a little similar like the pieces I work with. So now I'm going to do the inside, or else I have all my fingers already. And also a light color over here. But you see already how these change up. I also painted them in another DIY for the Valentine. But this time everything will be different. This one will be a different house. So I will do the rest of the house, and then I show you in a moment both of them how they are painted. So I'm trying if I like to distress it a little bit. I don't know if I like that or not. I am really not sure if I like this or like this or not. At least not with this decor piece. I don't know if I can just tap a little bit of the paint on the side of it and just do but I really don't like I really don't know if I like it or not. I really have to think about it. Maybe I like it, or maybe I don't. I really have no idea if I What do you, it's so sad that you don't get, you can't talk with me. I would love sometimes to ask your opinion, how you would do it and what color you would use. But sadly enough, that is not possible. Maybe one day we do a live, then we can talk. So this is a little bit how I would distress it. And I don't know if I compare it with this one and this one. I'm not sure if I like it or not, but we're going to distress it. If I don't like it, I always can paint it back. So I have to be careful that I don't use too much of the white. And I will be later back on the same spot. So I will finish this, and then we are going to see if I lit it this way or not. We will see that in a moment. So I am back again, but not I think you already see what's happened. I did distress it, but I really didn't like it, especially not for my decor. I loved the distressing, I really did. But when I compare it, because I want them inside of my kitchen for this Valentine and Easter season, because I will make it this way that I can change it up. So you see already, I just painted it in the black matte color again. So if you like the distressing, just do it whatever you want, because I didn't like it for my decor. So especially because I also painted my houses in the same color, and if you compare it with this, you can see this one is looking a little bit better with this color. So I am right now, what I'm going to do is do my arrows besides. I will lay them over here. What I will do is I have here a piece of my ribbon, and I'm going to, and I saw that this one is the same size as my houses. So what I'm going to do, because I want to give it a little bit piece of the Mackenzie Child print. So what I'm going to do is just place a little turn around my houses. You don't, like I said always, you don't have to do that. If you like it, it's okay. If you don't, it's okay too. So I am going to glue this on top of my wooden house. And I am start under my house, because that is then it doesn't see your the parts that come together. You don't see that much, because that's not always a great sight to see. I think I only going to place a little piece of glue on top of here, because I still want to use the house maybe later on. So I am only placing it on top of here. I have to do it at the right place. So, and now we're going to do it this way. And of course I pull it very hard, because I want to have it straight around my little house. I still hope you can see it, that I didn't do it out of camera. I don't hope so. So, but I will look it up in a moment if I did. Then I'll show you the second house. And of course, just cut it off and just do a little piece of glue. At least if my ribbon is want to work with me. And he doesn't. So this is also crafting. And of course, I have to pull it back a little bit more. And now I have to glue it on top of it. And now, of course, I work it a little bit, because you can see the sides, but this is a little bit of what I mean. So now your house is just simply turning into a little Mackenzie Child's house for only a little piece of ribbon. So you don't have to pay a lot of money for a piece of your Mackenzie Child. So I did it this way. I will do the second one, and then I show you what we're going to do with the houses further. So what you see here, I just went to my computer and I just found some pieces I could do inside of the house. I have the grain sack stripe, if I am correct. Is that, that's the way you call it, if I just a piece of plain red and pink. And of course I cut out some gnomes. So I don't really know what I will decide, but I probably will go for the gnomes. I don't know if I will do this one or this one. I will look for it and then I show you which one I chose. So for inside of my little house. But I think I do a piece of the gnomes, because I really love, and they are so cute. So I think this one will it be for what I will do inside of my little house. So you see, if you look at this one, you just cut your piece out and you just measure it with your little house. I already cut them out before I did a camera on, or else it will take so long for you. You see here, these are the two little gnomes that will be inside of the little houses. So if I am correct, everything will fit, and I don't even have to use some sticky gum. But if you want to do it, you still can, of course. And I hope this one is fitting also. I will look for it. And you see, they both are fitting inside of the little Mackenzie Child house. And I am so happy how they turned out. And of course you can mud podge them inside of your house. But I still want to use the houses again. So that's why I don't mud podge it. And I can really remove it very easily. I see it is a little bit coming up. So maybe I do a little bit of sticky gum inside of it. So I'm sure that he will stay in place. So, and then we are going to glue this one on top of the arrow. But first, before we're going to do that, I have found on AliExpress, like I told you earlier. Oh, I'm already sitting on my glue. This little package I have, so you can buy also this kind of little bicycle. So If you want to do it for the summer, make some little wooden house for the summer. You don't have to look to this, but if you use the wood color, you can use such a little bicycle in front of such a little house, and they don't cost almost nothing, and sending is free. But I also bought this little fence, if I am saying it correct. I will cut them on the right size, and then you see, you can use them as little vents for your little house, and it looks so nice. So I'm going to do this one, I measure this one out, and then I will do some wax on top of it, but I show you that in a moment. I think it's finishes off a little bit more, so I'm going to do that first. And then I will showing you how this is looking like. So you see, I glued the little house of the little houses, the little fence on the houses. And what I'm going to do right now, just to do a little bit of the furniture wax on top of it, not too much, because or else it will be everywhere. And you see, here will dark up. I have to do the sides, or else it doesn't look very nice. I will do that. But you see already a little bit how it will turn out. How he is changing, just color the little fences. And I am so happy how this is looking like. And just with some easy wood, I think they use it normally for scrapbooking. If you go to look on AliExpress, just also type in scrapbooking, wooden pieces for scrapbooking, and then you also find a lot. I still need a lot of my pieces which they need to come in, because I ordered them already. So, and like I said, sending is free. So maybe you just, if you never did something with AliExpress, maybe just try it sometimes, and you will see it is very handy. And normally you just have to look for very cheap, and if you think it's too expensive, just don't buy it. Just look for things, they are very inexpensive, and you don't have to pay sending costs. That's very important, because I never pay sending costs. So you see, I am so happy how it is looking like. So I will do the second one, and then we are going to really glue the houses on top of my arrows. So what I'm going to do right now is just place my little house on top of my arrow. So I'm first going to glue it. And I hope then he will stick on top of my, only with some glue from my glue gun. I'm trying to get it inside of the middle of my arrow and just push it so it will stay in place. And you see, it is a very easy DIY. You just need an arrow, you probably find in the wedding section, just some twine around the middle, a little wooden house, painted black, a little print in it, and some little fence. And you already have a nice decor piece for in your home. And it is unique, because you do whatever you want and the print whatever you want. I really am happy how he's turning out. I will do the second one, and then I show you the end result. So here you see how my two arrows turned out. I really love the cute little gnomes I did on my computer, and the little fence in front of the little wooden houses. So I just like the way they are turned out, especially the sides with a little bit of the Mackenzie child print. So you can make one piece of your own. I did some greenery behind the fence, so give it also a little bit a touch of my own. I love greenery, so I'm very happy how this arrows turned out. And I just hope you just take something of your own and just make something unique for your own. You will see, you will love it. And I am just happy you came along with me in my DIY and just made this DIY a little bit together. I hope you just got a little bit of inspiration with you. And that's all I hope, just take a little bit of inspiration with you. But I'm happy how mine turned out. My DIY for this challenge. I hope you enjoyed watching, and of course thank you so much Fanny and thank you so much Maria for hosting this Twine It Up challenge together. It was a really fun challenge to join, so everyone go check out the playlist with tons of beautiful inspiration. And from Diane and me, we hope of course if you like this content and you want to see more videos of our from Easter for the Valentine, I hope you will consider subscribing and of course click the bell so you will be notified every time we upload our video. Like I always say, enough talking. We wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Stay safe, take care of yourself, and take care of each other. And we really hope to see you in our next video. Love from Diane and me. Bye, everyone.